Hello students, this is Namrata from Sunstar Global School and before this I would like to tell you that we have already discussed and revised two chapters that are coming in our assessment 2, test number 1 and this is the third one. It is also going to be asked in your exam. So here we are going to discuss chapters 8, the story of water. And we have learned already this chapter, but I am going to revise this chapter so that you can be 100% sure while you are answering all the questions. So what we are going to revise in this chapter, the sources of water, that means from where we are getting water, rather it is lake, well, tube well, pond, bowri, johar, there are different kinds of sources of water given in your book. So all the sources of water we are going to revise. Second one is the state of water. In what kind of states water is available on earth? Do you know that 73% of earth is covered with water, but only 3% water is fit for drinking? So the states of water, that means in which condition water is available in our earth. Like somewhere it is found in form of vapors, somewhere it is found in form of ice, and somewhere it is found in the form of water. That means there are three states of water that is available on earth: liquid, gas and solid. And the water cycle, that means water is converting from one condition to another, another to another, and that process is continuously going on. That is why it is called a cycle. So these are the three things we are going to revise: sources of water, the states of water and the water cycle. These are the sources of water in the past. Some of the sources are using in present also. And do you know that water is available all over the earth and we get water from the different sources of water? So these are main sources of water. They were used as a source of water in the past. So just like lake. What is a lake? Well, a rain is being dumped and water gets accumulated, snow is melted, then also it is get accumulated in a place. Suppose this is a place and here the rain water gets accumulated and this water is available throughout the year, so then it is called a lake. Like in Jammu and Kashmir, the Dal Lake, it is very famous. In the previous chapter we have already discussed about Dal Lake. Why? Because it is important as a source of income in Srinagar, because people are using houseboats over there and they have beautifully decorated it to earn money, because it is the most attractive part of tourism in Jammu and Kashmir. So what happened? In the cold season, in winters, the lake is frozen. But when it is summer, the ice get melted and then water is available over there, so then it is available in the form of a lake. So people are using lake as a source of water. Next one is Johar. Second one is Johar. What is a Johar? Johar is a dam or the earthen dam. It was made in the earlier time to conserve the water and it was used throughout the year. See, suppose this is a Johar. So it is an earthen dam and it was used as a source of water throughout the year because rain water is stored in it and it was used as a water reservoir. Next one is well. What is a well? See, well is a deep hole made into the earth to get water from the earth. So what is a well? Well is a deep hole made into the earth to get water from the earth, and it was also used as a source of water. People were using it even before few years it was in use, but nowadays we are using tube wells, water supply pipes. So it was used in the previous earlier days. In this well there was a rope, and that is tied with a bucket, and bucket has to throw into the well, and you have to pull the bucket at, and it is filled with water. So it was a well. What is a step well? Step well is you can call it as a bowl also. It was also used as a source of a water. See, its name is a step and well. Step well. So there are some steps are made over there to go into the water and take the water from the step well. See, these all were used as a source of water in the earlier days. Some people are also using this as a source of water nowadays as well. Okay. And next one is natural sources of water. See, these are the man-made, and actually it is not a man-made, but by nature it is made. Now we are going to discuss sources of water that is natural, like river, pond, seas. So these are the natural sources of water. What is the next topic is? Natural sources of water. So now, as the topic's name suggests, natural sources of water. That means sources that is naturally available, like river, pond, oceans, and seas. River. First one is river. What is a river? River is a source of water that is continuously gets water from the melting of snow from the mountains, like Ganga. Do you know where it is originated, Ganga? Yes, Gangotri. This is the origin point of Ganga River, and it is found in Himalayas. So, river, what is a river? River is a natural source of water, or it is a natural source of running water that gets water from the melting of ice from the mountains. Like Ganga, Yamuna, they are getting water from the melting of ice. Continuously they are running. Pond. Pond is a source of water that is found on land. Okay? Oceans, they are found on land, but they are the largest source of water on land. And all the rivers are getting accumulated or getting down to the oceans and seas. And oceans and seas water is salty, so we cannot drink it because it is salty. And see here one more important thing it is given, that Agrasen ki Bauli. It is a specific name. Agrasen ki Bauli is an ancient stepwell in New Delhi. Where it is in New Delhi, and according to some historical records, it belongs to the era of Mahabharat. So when Mahabharat was there, from that time it is nowadays also available on land. What is that? Agrasen ki Bauli. Agrasen ki Bauli. So here we have discussed different sources of water, like sources of water in the past: lake, pond, well. Sources of water in the past were your Johar, lake, well, and step well. And now we have discussed natural sources of water like river, pond, ocean, and seas. River are the continuously flowing water sources that get water from the melting of snow from the mountains. Now, what you have to do, you have to read the chapter thoroughly so that you can answer all kind of questions properly, because in your assessment 2, in test number 1, there are 3 chapters are coming. Chapter 6, the birds, world of birds, and chapter 7, see, I will show you different types of birds, housing and clothing, and the story of water. These are the 3 chapters we have to learn. You don't need to write, but as well you have to learn all the chapters thoroughly so that you can answer properly. In the next video we will discuss the same chapter. Here we have discussed only half of the chapter, because it will be more than the content if I will explain you the whole chapter in first, only in one video. But I will explain you this chapter in the part 2 as well, and the water cycle is remaining in this chapter. One thing I would like to explain you, pond. See, pond is the water source that is available on land. And these sources, like river and pond, they are used to gain water from the deep inside the earth. And in the next video, we will discuss question answers too, and the all extra exercise given in your book, so that you can learn all the exercises. As before, we have discussed already chapter 6 and chapter 7, how the question and answer, fill in the blanks, multiple choice questions. And chapter 7, we have already discussed the local government. Do you remember what was that? What was in that? Gram Panchayat, Municipal Corporation. So please read your book thoroughly. It is very important to answer properly, particularly, and perfectly. Thank you.